of our 11-year-old female California sea lions. And as the name suggests, California sea lions are native to the western coastline of the Americas, all the way from British Columbia down to Ecuador. But Jet, she's never been to the West Coast.
Nope.
She's a southern girl. She was actually born at SeaWorld of Orlando, and she came to live with us about 9 years ago. Now, Jet lives here with some of her friends and her family. She has two boyfriends. It's very scandalous. Yes. Wilbur, who's 21, and Tucker, who's 14. Then she has two friends, Monica and Malvin, who are 5. A new friend, she can't help but smile.
Wow, that's a beautiful smile, isn't it?
Yeah.
That's a little scary looking though, right? Do you guys see all of her beautiful curly white teeth in there?
Oh,
good grief, did you guys see those? They're not curly white. Sea lions don't brush their teeth, they don't go to the dentist, they don't even chew their food, they swallow everything whole. That dark coloration is totally normal for them. It just comes on with the pain. Now, Miss Jack here is a huge fan of country and western music. Do you have any fans out there? Yeah, yeah, score it, get it, Jody. Now, you guys recognize the tune? No, not even over here? Yeah, I didn't really see us singing along. Well, it was a Golden Oldie by Kenny Rogers. You picked a fine time to leave me, you steal. Oh, Jody, look at that. Oh, no. We went and we embarrassed Jet. Do you guys know how we embarrassed her? You called her a seal. Is she a seal?
No.
She's a sea lion. And we're going to point out the differences a little later on in the show so that you guys never get confused and we don't embarrass any sea lions in the future. Now, if you guys look in the front of Jet's face, you're going to notice she has some whiskers. Now, those whiskers are called vibrissae. They can feel vibrations on land and in the water. They help sea lions to feel the different size and shapes of different objects, which helps them to find the ball balance. You're going to notice when Jody tosses that ball onto Jet's nose, then her whiskers will pop up. But they won't be supporting the ball, they're just telling her which way to wiggle to keep it balanced. Pretty cool, right?
Yeah!
Very nice. You guys, some of you look that impressed by that. She'll go get it from the water. She'll make her way all the way back up to the stage, where she will come onto land. Oh! She will she's gonna get ready, so she'll go right back to her seat. And like every great performer, she will crack a pose. That was still pretty impressive, even with those obstacles in the way, huh? Very nice, Jet. Yeah, Jet's gonna get a lot of fish with fun behaviors like that one. She's getting some hands, some fingers, some squid. She's also enjoying some Jell-O. Yeah, now dolphins and sea lions, they don't drink salt water and they don't drink fresh water. They get all their water from the food that they eat. So we can train them to eat Jell-O as well as ice cubes for a little extra hydration. She said she thought she saw a shark in the lagoon behind her. Oh, this is very scary. Jaw-droppingly so. Oh no. Okay guys, I'm sorry, but we have to stop the show. I don't know though, Jet did tell us if she ever saw a shark that she would faint, so I don't know if I believe her. What? Jody, look at that. Oh, she did faint. Oh no, I'm so sorry. Okay, we do have to stop the show. It's just gonna take a second though. Just stay in your seats, okay? And Jet, look importantly, hold right there. Jody's gonna check the water. All right, let's make sure there is nothing in there, guys. What are you looking at? Oh, Jody, there is a shark in there. Wait a minute, where's Jet?
Wait a minute. I recognize that flipper and
look at that guilty smile. Oh, it was her the whole time, wasn't it? Oh, Jet, you should be ashamed of yourself. You know what? If she does that again, she might need a little spank. Oh, I can't believe she did that. Now, Jody is a little newer to working with Jet, so it could be their relationship. Now, our sea lions and us, we have this amazing relationship, and it's built on some very important things. There's a lot of love.
a lot of trust.
It's just a little bit of fish, you know?
Yeah, I know, lots of fish.
Now you guys have seen the love and you have seen the fish, but I think we should test out the trust. So to do that, we're gonna give her a fish. Jody's gonna ask her to hold it and not eat it. Now this will be difficult because she's eating about 15 pounds of fish every single day. Like a frisbee. The next one, a little more difficult. She'll dive through it. And the last one, even more difficult with some flips. Boom, she hit them all. That was awesome. Very nice. Now, I have a question for you guys. What do you think the jet feels like? Why don't you raise your hands if you think she has smooth skin like an elephant? Nobody? All right, how about maybe one up here? Feathers like a parrot? Nobody on that one? How about fur like a dog? One or two? Scales like a fish? Okay, who has no idea? Yeah, there you guys are. It's okay to admit, it's really hard to tell, especially when she's all sleek and smooth from the water. But this pretty girl is actually covered in fur. She's a male just like you and me, and she even has a little belly button. Now her fur, her whiskers, her flippers, they all point back. With all those features pointing backwards, it allows the sea lions to swim up to 23 miles per hour, which in fact is faster than the dolphins. Yeah. But you know what? Like you see here at Sea Lion Stadium, we still think that dolphins are pretty cool. What is she doing over there? Oh my goodness, she is sticking her tongue out at the dolphin. Please don't tell the dolphin trainer she did that. I'm sure she didn't mean it. You admire them, right? Oh. Okay, yeah, we're definitely going to keep that between us there. Now, Jody and I, we've been working on our upcoming magic act. Are you guys big fans of magic? Yeah? Well, Jet is learning to be a beautiful assistant. Would you guys like to see some magic today?
Yes.
Yeah? All right. Well, for Jody's first act, she is actually going to turn Jet into a walrus right before your very eyes. But don't worry, she'll turn her back. Abracadabra. Hocus pocus. She's a walrus. And right back into a sea lion. What do you guys think of that magic? Oh, wow. It was like 4 o'clock. Okay, we're going to keep going. Next act, you might like more. We're going to make the sea lion's head completely disappear. All right, on the count of three. 3, 2, 1. And it's back. Does she do it? Wow. Oh, don't worry everybody, all right? We're gonna take the hint out there. We're just gonna stick to training. Now, I'm going to give some of you guys an opportunity to come down here and get to know Jet a little better by either tossing a ring to her or being her trainer. But before you raise your hand to volunteer, I do ask you not volunteer if you or anyone in your party has interacted with a wild gray mammal in the past 2 days. So that means if you've helped out with a stranding or interacted with a wild dolphin or a wild manatee. That being said, if you or anyone in your group has not interacted with a behavior, why don't you just throw your finger on this and think it's awesome. Good job. Yay. Ranger Behavior. Hey, Hager, why don't you ask her to stick out her tongue? Give her a big thumbs up and say, say cheese. Very nice. Bring her left hand. You're going to slap your knee and then point up at the sky and say, jump. One more time for me, a little quicker.
There you go.
Very nice. You're going to reach your hand towards her like this and say, give yourself a hand. Turn this way for me a little bit. So turn this way. There you go. Now put your hand back and reach towards it. Give yourself a hand a little louder. But she figured it out. She's like, I figured it out. 1 second. She's gonna go first. And then you can throw it. Watch out, Jody. You might get taken out on this one. That's like, really? Everybody close your eyes. It was there the whole time. Ready? Ta-da! Awesome. Okay, let's have you kind of wave it like this till she sees it. Wave till she sees you. There you go. Perfect. All
Alright, now this gentleman over here. He's like, guys, I got some obstacles on the way. I'm gonna need to rearrange. Alright, guys, you should all duck. We're terrified. There you go. Good ducking in the front row. Awesome, everybody. Yeah. Here. Have to bow on out of here. Woo! Very nice, Miss Jess. That was awesome. We're going to just have a moment to switch out the animals, and then we're going to come right back in with just a boyfriend, Tucker. Isn't he handsome? Now, earlier we told you guys that these are sea lions. They're not seals. We're going to point out the differences with his health. The first difference, if you look on either side of his cute little head, are those external ear flaps. Good. A seal just has a hole behind the eye. Now, sea lions like Tucker, they have very large and powerful front flippers that they use in a flying-like motion to propel themselves through the water.
Good.
Whereas a seal has a much smaller front flipper and they use it to steer through the water. Now, sea lions' front flippers are so powerful they can use it to support their entire body weight even on just the front flippers. Target. Good boy! Now those flippers are also powerful enough to allow for him to leap up to 8 to 10 feet out of the water depending on the depth of the water. So if you focus your attention to the ball above the pool, Tucker will show off his jump. Good boy, T! Now the last difference between seals and sea lions is how they move on land. Sea lions can rotate their rear flippers underneath themselves, allowing them to walk on all four like a dog. Good. But a seal can't move that way. A seal has a fixed pelvic bone, and when they move on land, they scoot on their belly, and they kind of look like a giant inchworm. Now, T, he has never seen a seal, but he does have a really good impression of what he thinks one might look like. Seal. Good boy, Tucker. What a nice impression. That was awesome. Now, some of you guys are probably wondering how we train our animals. Here at Theater, we use a form of training called operantesis. It's a target pole. It's just an extension of my arm. Now, Tucker is trained to remain in contact with the target pole until he hears the magic word, good. Yeah, you can imagine he knows the word good really well, right? Yeah, it means fish is going to follow. But I think we should see how well by saying other words to fool him. So I'll say some and then you guys can shout some out and we'll give those a try too. Target. Stop. Let go. Give up. You guys have any? Whale.
Jump.
Shark. Should. Feel. Would. What was that? Good. There it was. He was definitely paying attention. So then we use this target pole to shape natural behavior into show behaviors. If we want a head shake, yes, we move it up and down. A head shake goes side to side. If Tucker's being a weirdo, we go in a circle. He'll stay there till I say the magic word. But now later on, we're going to fade out the target pole. We assign him hands that go up and ask for the behavior. So when I make a motion, he recognizes it. Good. We can also assign verbal cues because sea lions have excellent hearing above and below the water. So then all I do is say, smile, say cheese, speak. Yeah. Now we can also use the target poles over the water and then fade out the target poles. And that's how we get fun behaviors like our, you want to do that one? It's fine, like our T-spin. Close your attention right here in the center as Tucker shows off. Good boy, very nice. Now I do hope all of you have had a wonderful time hanging out here with this handsome boy and his beautiful girlfriend, Miss Jet, and Jody, of course, as well. But it has come time for Mr. T here to belly flop on out of here. Good boy, very nice, T. Let's give him one last round of applause.